This is how to relate K, Q, and free energy. Consider the acid-base reaction at 25 degrees Celsius. All our materials are in aqueous phase, and we're given the equilibrium value of 0.045. The first question asks, what is the value of delta G naught? For that, we can use the formula delta G naught is equal to minus RT natural log of K. So that would be a minus 0.008314 kilojoules per mole Kelvin times our temperature to 98.15 Kelvin times the natural log of 0.045. Putting that into our calculator, we will get a plus 7.68 kilojoules per mole. That is the free energy at standard state. Now we're asked, if we're under a specific set of conditions, what are the values of Q and free energy at room temperature under each set of conditions? Okay, I will write down the value of K for each set of conditions for easy comparison. So let's look at the first one. K does not change at this temperature, it's 0.045. Q at this temperature is going to be equal to products over reactants raised to their coefficients. So that would be 1 molar acetate, 0.5 molar nitrous acid over 0.01 molar acetic acid and 0.1 molar nitrite. Putting that into my calculator, I'm going to get a value of 500 or 5.0 times 10 to the second. Okay, Q is greatly in excess of K, so the reaction is going to proceed to the left and want to make more reactant. But let's check that against the value of the free energy. The formula for free energy is that it is equal to free energy at standard state plus RT natural log of Q. I have my free energy at standard state. That was the 7.68 I already calculated, plus 0.008314 times 298.15K times, sorry, I'm going to write it on the next line, natural log of 500. All right, when I put that all into my calculator, it gives me a value of 23.05 kilojoules per mole of reaction, and that is definitely a delta G that is positive. So once again, this says, reaction, please go and make reactant. Let's try the next set of conditions, B2. My K value is the same, 0.045. My Q this time is going to be equal to 0.021 times 0.019 over 0.088 times 0.1. And when I calculate that out, it turns out to be, oh, look at that, it's the equilibrium constant. So which way does the reaction go? Well, kind of neither. It proceeds to the left and to the right at equal rates. Now, if we're at equilibrium, the free energy change should actually be zero, so let's just double check that. That should be equal to 7.68 plus 0.008314 times 298.15 Kelvin times the natural log of 0.045. And when I put that all into my calculator, plus or minus a little bit of air, it looks like it is honestly a free energy of zero, which is what it should be at equilibrium. Okay, let's see if we can manage to get this reaction to go to the right. Example number B3. The equilibrium constant is 0.045, and my Q value is going to be equal to 0.15 times 0.15 over 0.12 times 0.12. I get a value of 1.56. I guess to be technically correct, it should be 1.6. So I'm afraid this reaction still is going to proceed to the left because Q is greater than K, but not as strongly as it was before. If we have just a little bit less product, we might be able to get this one to finally go to the right, but so far it's still going to the left in our current concentrations. And that means our free energy should be positive, so let's just check that. 7.68 plus 0.008314 times 298.15 Kelvin times the natural log of 1. I'll carry the extra sig fig in just to make sure everything's good. And I am at a free energy of 8.78 kilojoules per mole of reaction. Okay, well, it's not as positive as it was in example B1, but it still says that we're going to be more toward reactant. We have to get this to negative in order to make the reaction want to proceed to the right. But we don't have that set of conditions. All right, that's all.